In this video, we're going to start the KutaSoftware free Infinite Algebra 2 worksheet review of linear equations. And in this first video, I'm going to complete the first page. The directions for the first page state to sketch the graph of each line. In number 1, we have y equals negative 2x minus 2. If you notice, y equals negative 2x minus 2 is in slope-intercept form, which we know is y equals mx plus b, where m is the slope and b is the y-intercept. So for number 1, our slope m is equal to negative 2, and our y-intercept b is also equal to negative 2. Subtracting a positive is the same as adding a negative. So in order to graph number 1, we're going to start by graphing the y-intercept. So when x is equal to 0, our y-intercept b is negative 2. So we'll locate 0 in the x direction and negative 2 in the y direction and plot that point. Knowing our slope, we'll be able to find our next point. Remember, slope is rise over run, so we can think of negative 2 as negative 2 over a positive 1. Rise over run, that's going to be down 2 and 1 to the right. So from the point we've already plotted, we're going to go down 2 and 1 to the right, or 1 in the positive x direction and 2 in the negative y direction. Then we'll plot our new point. Now that we have two points, all we have to do is draw a line and connect. And let's go ahead and double check. Let's plug in the point negative 2, positive 2. So y equals negative 2 times x minus 2. We're going to plug in negative 2 for x, so this is going to be negative 2 times negative 2 minus 2, and we're going to plug in a positive 2 for y. So we have to see if 2 equals negative 2 times negative 2 minus 2. So it'll be 2 equals negative 2 times negative 2 is a positive 4, and we're subtracting 2. 2 does indeed equal 4 minus 2, which is 2. So you can see that negative 2, 2 is true for number 1. And that's just a way to double check the graph of a line. Pick another point that falls on that line, plug it into the equation, and see if that equation is true. So in number 1, we graphed using the slope and the y-intercept. In number 2, let's graph using a table of x and y values. So number 2 says y equals negative x minus 2. So we're going to do a t-table of x and y values. Let's plug in 0 for x, and we'll also plug in 1 for x. In order to make a line, we only need 2 points. So when x is 0, we'll have y equals negative 0, which is simply 0, minus 2. So when x is 0, y is going to equal 0 minus 2, which is negative 2. And when x is equal to 1, we'll plug in 1 for x, so y equals negative 1, the opposite of x, or negative x is the opposite of 1, which is negative 1, and we're going to subtract 2. So y equals negative 1 minus 2, which is negative 3. So when x is 1, y is negative 3. Now that we have two separate points, we'll go ahead and plot those. And to double check number 2, we know that this is slope-intercept form, y equals mx plus b. So our b value is negative 2. So when x is 0, y should be negative 2, and indeed, that is true. Let's move on to number 3. In number 3, we have 2x minus 5y equals 5. I'm going to rewrite number 3 in slope-intercept form, and then graph using the slope and y-intercept. So in order to get to slope-intercept form, I need to isolate the y. So I'm going to start by subtracting 2x from both sides. That'll give me that negative 5y equals negative 2x plus a positive 5. My next step, I'm going to divide both sides by negative 5. So I'll get that y, since negative 5 divided by negative 5 is 1, and 1 times y is a positive y. So y equals negative 2 over negative 5 times x, so positive 2/5 x plus 5 over negative 5, because remember, we're dividing negative 2x by negative 5, and we're dividing positive 5 by negative 5. So positive 5 divided by negative 5 is going to be a negative 1. So my slope m is equal to 2/5, and my y-intercept b is negative 1. So when x is 0, y is negative 1, and then using rise over run, I'm going to go up 2, since that's the rise, and positive 5, so to the right, 5 is the run. So starting from the point I've already plotted, up 2, and then over 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So the next point I'm going to plot is 5, positive 1. And then I'll just draw a line connecting those two points. And that's my answer for number 3. In number 4, I have x equals negative 1. That means that for whatever value I plug in for y, x is always going to be negative 1. So if I plug in 1 for y, x is negative 1. If I plug in 5 for y, the value doesn't matter, x is still negative 1. If I plug in negative 6 for y, x is still negative 1. As you can see in number 4, we have a vertical line. Moving on to number 5, 32 minus 2x equals 8y. I'm going to rearrange the equation number 5 so that I have slope-intercept form. In order to do that, all I have to do is divide both sides by a positive 8. 32 divided by 8 is a positive 4, and we're going to subtract 2x over 8, which is 1/4 x. And that is equal to y. So y is equal to mx, negative 1/4 x, plus b, or plus 4. My slope m is negative 1/4, and my y-intercept b is a positive 4. So when x is equal to 0, y is 4, and I have negative 1 over 4 for my rise over run, so I'm going to go down 1 and over 4 to the right from the point I've already plotted. So down 1, 4 to the right, I will plot point 4, 3. And then once I have two points, I can form my line. And that's my answer in number 6. If I wanted to, I could also write the slope as opposed to negative 1 over positive 4. I could write it as positive 1 over negative 4, since that still gives me a slope of negative 1/4. So as opposed to going down 1 and 4 to the right, I'm going to go up 1 and 4 to the left. So if I were to start at my original point, my y-intercept, I would go up 1 and 4 to the left. And you can see that again, I fall on the line that is my answer in number 5. And lastly in this video, number 6. I prefer solving my equation for slope-intercept form and then graphing, so I'm going to do that. I'll start by subtracting 1/4 y from both sides. So I'll have negative 1/4 y equal to x plus 1/2. My next step, I'm going to multiply by a negative 4. Multiplying both sides by a negative 4, negative 4 times negative 1/4 is a positive 1, and 1 times y is y. And that's going to be equal to x plus 1/2 times negative 4. So I'm going to have to distribute that negative 4. Negative 4 times x is negative 4x, plus negative 4 times 1/2 is a negative 2. So number 6, my slope m is negative 4, and my y-intercept b is negative 2. So graphing 0, negative 2, and then my rise over run, which I can write as negative 4 over 1. So I'm going to go 4 down and 1 to the right from the point I've already plotted. So 4 down and 1 to the right. That will give me point 1, negative 6. Now I'll go ahead, connect those two points, and that will be my line in number 6. And with that answer, we'll wrap up this video. Join me in the next video, where I'll continue on with this worksheet, completing numbers 7 through 14. If you haven't already, give me a thumbs up on this video, and also while you're clicking that like button, go ahead and click the subscribe button. All likes and subscriptions are greatly appreciated.